A lot of Adventist churches just want to hear pop psychology. When this opportunity came up for me to pastor here, you have to make a decision. Well, what are you going to focus on? You come to Christ if God has given you the gift to share, to teach, to preach. You have to make the decision what's your focus going to be on. What are you going to present to these people? And when I came into the Adventist Church, and I came out of, I told you that, I came out of, as a child, Catholicism, and then I studied every mainline Protestant church, looked at their teachings, their views, compared it to Scripture, and came into the Adventist Church because in the Adventist Church, the message that I heard was a more complete picture of Jesus Christ. But the biggest problem I had when I first came into this church was their understanding of righteousness by faith. Because I saw a church that was just bound in legalism. And I saw myself falling into that same trap. And I started to think back of what I learned from these other Protestant churches about righteousness by faith. And I got to tell you that I learned a lot. And when I started comparing that to what I was learning in Adventism, I started to see that, you know, I'm works oriented. And that's not what Christ had called me for. But it wasn't until years later that I started to hear the true gospel proclaimed in the Adventist Church. And I shared this with you last week, the true nature of what Jesus did for me, that in taking on my nature, because I came out of Catholicism, and in Catholicism, I needed not just Mary's help, but I needed 1,000 other saints to get me to Christ. And that Christ could never, ever, this is what they taught me as a child, Christ could never, ever even come close to understanding who I am or what I am. Because he's so high. This is why you need the intervention of the saints. And I was thinking, wow, what hope do I have? And I saw a presentation of the nature of Christ. And that touched and broke my heart. And I started to see Jesus for who he was. And I started to get a much clearer understanding of why God raised this church and the message that this church had been given. That in 1888, God again broke through into human history to raise up messengers to proclaim what righteousness by faith really is. And it was a message that Martin Luther did not have, that the reformers who came before him and after him did not have. Why? Because if you know anything about time prophecy, as we were shown in our Sabbath school class, you guys really need to come to the Sabbath school class, you start to understand that God, in this great time prophecy, has shown us and has prepared us for everything that he's going to do. And that God raised up a most precious message. And that in that message was shown that Christ is not so far away from me, but Christ knows what it's like to be me. Amen. And that everything that I go through, everything that I deal with, he's able to help me. He's able to give me victory. And believe me, brothers and sisters, I need a lot of victory. I told you before, we're like onions. You sit us out too long, we stink. You get us when we're fresh, you start peeling away, we have layers, right? And it's the core of us. There's a lot of that part that nobody ever sees. You can hide it, but you can't hide it from God. And so each layer is maybe different masks that we wear. different personas that we put on. And Christ has come to peel those layers back, peel those layers back, peel those layers back, till he gets to the core of you. And that's where he lives. Okay? All that stuff, all those burdens, all that craziness, Christ has come to free you from. And if the Son has set you free, you are what?
Free.
You are free indeed. Well, I went 5 minutes over my time. This is an ongoing series. There is something that I need to share with you. Those of you that are members here, have been coming here, some of you may have heard, and I want to tell you now that last month, at our last board meeting, I gave my resignation to the board. I also sent that resignation into the conference. Where we're at as a church, I've been here now, this is going on 11 years. You guys need for you to go to whatever level God has for you. It's time for new leadership. But I gave my presentation to the conference, and they never even acknowledged.
They will.
So you're stuck with me until they decide what's going to happen. But something at some point will happen. So instead of everybody hearing it second, third, fourth hand, I wanted to tell you myself. So, as a church, we did our nominating committee. One of the things that we wanted to focus on was getting different people for different positions, so it's not the same people doing the same work year after year after year. This church, this is how this church works. It'll grow, and it'll plateau, and it'll go backwards. And then it'll grow, and it'll plateau, and then it'll go backwards. And you have to decide what you want, where you want to go. You need to decide what kind of church you want. What's the foundational principles that you stand on? You have some very good teachers here. You have been given some great instruction, and that will continue. What are you going to do with that instruction? There are people that come in here that would like to change this church. There are people who come in here who have agendas. That happens every church, but small churches are, it seems to happen in small churches a lot more, because they think they can come in and they can gain disciples for themselves. Know what you believe. Understand why you believe it. And be able to explain what you believe. Because if you cannot, if you can't do that yourself, then I have failed you. You need to be students of God's Word. You need to be able to stand and not rely on me as the pastor, as Ricky as the head elder, as Chuck as one of the Sabbath school teachers and preachers here. You need to be able for yourself to understand these great truths that are contained in Scripture. Because we're not always going to be here. Like I said, I have turned in my resignation. At some point, I will be stepping down. You will be getting new leaders here. You need to decide where you're going to go from here, what kind of church you're going to be, what you're going to continue to preach and teach and believe. The closing hymn this morning is hymn number 594.